Mr. Schmidt and I met at a diner in Keene, New Hampshire, 1960.
Jim! Mr. Schmidt. I read your transcript, Jim. You've had a rough 2 years. It says you were suspended for saying you didn't believe in God. Is that true?
It's true that I said it, but I didn't mean it.
Then why'd you say it?
I was just trying to make the teacher. Brother Henry. He taught religion, but the way he taught it, he just read from the book. He didn't like questions. So I raised my hand to say he didn't believe in God and to see what he'd do.
And what did he do?
He sent me to the prison.
It's a serious thing to say you don't believe in God, Jim. What got into you?
Well, the thought came into my head to say I didn't believe in God, and I thought, who put that thought there? And I thought it was probably God, you know.
What if it was the other guy?
I don't think so. I think the devil would want me to be lazy, and God would want me to speak.
I teach religion, comparative religion. Now, unlike your friend, Brother Henry, I don't read to the class through some book. I understand you attended a retreat at my school, sponsored by OSDA. You met a member of our faculty there, Alan Hoffman. Said you were very good at charades.
You did?
Yes, apparently you guessed the Rubaiyat of Omar Khayyam after one clue.
I really like that poem. I wish I could live like that guy. He saw day and night like a chessboard, and God was his big finger writing in the sky. He was free.
So why do you think you did so poorly at your last school?
I don't know. Felt like his prime, they just didn't do it. All the classrooms, everything they need to believe.
Thomas More is different than that. The school's an old mansion and the student body size is very small. The way I figure your credits, you can go into junior year.
I can?
Barely, but yes. I'll give you a scholarship for the tuition, but your parents will have to pay for the room and board.
Is that all?
Oh no, it's not too much.
How much?
$900?
Sounds like a lot.
Your mother said it was all right.
Why would you give me a scholarship? I flunked everything.
I think you can do the work. And your mother cried to me on the phone. Make use of the opportunity. All right, I've got to get back. When does the train come?
In about 2 hours.
You'll be all right?
Sure. I have a book. Got it across the street.
Well, see you then.
Thank you, sir. And I thought... wow. I'm saved. I stole this book. Thomas More School, Harrisville, New Hampshire, fall semester.
Hi, Alan.
You have a minute?
Sure, I was just reading the paper you left in my box. Jim Quinton's opus about the Nazis. He has an unusual conscience.
And he's an overheated adolescent who likes to get a rise out of people.
He sounds like he wants to dig Hitler up and kill him again.
He writes very well.
Yes, but I heard from Rooney that he's failing chemistry.
Well, he's ace in English.
That's his natural strength. Real discipline is overcoming your weak suit.
You're right.
He's in my comparative religion class, and he's become a little obsessed with Taoism. I usually spend 10 minutes on it, but he's kept it alive for 2 days.
Who knew ancestor worship was so fascinating?
The more I explain it to him, the more I think I may inadvertently be making a convert. I had to remind him he's a Catholic.
I wonder what that's about.
I don't know. Kids get their enthusiasms. I want you to look out for him. He's the most interesting mess we had this year.
He looks up to you.
Yeah, let's keep it that way. I can't be his friend, but you can. But refrain from the brainwashing.
Of course.
You're good with the troubled ones. Thank you.
you have a chance to read Phaedo?
Yes, but Socrates is incredible. He wasn't afraid of anything.
He had the courage of his convictions.
Right. But in a way, I don't get it. All he had to do was say what they wanted and everything would have been okay. But because of his personality, he couldn't.
There goes your queen.
Mr. Schmidt has reservations about you.
What do you mean?
He suspects you were the thief at the carriage house.
It wasn't me.
I believe you. It's just you were really artificially casual that night.
I was not.
Look, Jim, I think the world of you. People make mistakes. But if there's something weighing on you, for your own burden, for your own good, you might want to unburden yourself.
Never should have put it to me like that.
I think you want to talk.
You won't tell him.
I'm on your side.
Okay, it was me.
Look, you just need to stop screwing up and go ahead and have a great senior year. Can you do that for me?
Yeah. I wish I knew Socrates.
He would have liked you.
Spring of 1961, I was 17.
How are you doing, Jim?
Fine.
It's been a long year, Mr. Quinn, a very long year.
2 years, really, almost.
Tomorrow's graduation. Do you think you should graduate?
Yeah.
Remember that break-in over at Silver Lake last year, not that long after you joined us? Remember when I asked you about that?
I didn't do it.
And then Kendall's record collection.
I didn't touch his records. They searched my room.
Yes, they did. Were you drunk last night?
No.
The school nurse thought you were drunk.
I was sick.
I threw Bigford out at Christmas for smoking marijuana. I think I should have done the same for you, too.
Or what? I didn't do anything.
Are you really saying that?
Look, please don't throw me out, Mr. Schmidt.
Why shouldn't I?
Why shouldn't you?
You know what I don't understand? You're a cheat. You're close to incapable of telling the truth about your work. There you have areas where it's clear to me that you're driven by the very highest ideals. Now, how can that be?
You've read my essays?
Yes, I've read them all.
Why?
Because I'm trying to make a determination here.
This place has helped me a lot.
I don't believe you. You've beaten up half the freshman class. You're widely disliked. What would you do if you were me? You've shown no particular desire to protect your place here.
I'm passing my courses.
More to this school than just grades. Character is an issue.
What do you want me to say? You start off with things I'm worth it.
Worth what?
The trouble, I guess.
I talked to Mr. Hoffman. He thinks you should graduate.
Well, shouldn't that count? Mr. Hoffman, when I wrote things, he thought they were good.
Was he
thought
right?
I was good.
Was he right?
You don't think I'm good.
Convince me.
So Omar Khayyam got me in. A dead guy.
Did he tell you to get drunk?
I didn't get drunk!
This is so unfair. What are you talking about? It's my school!
Right. You're the guy.
What would you call
it fair? This is just... You have everything!
What are you talking about? It's my school! You're here because I've given you the opportunity!
Why is it your school? Why am I always in the wrong? Why do I have to listen to you when you have zero to say? Because I'm young? Unlike life, I've been young. So I never get a turn? The school's lost, if you ask me. You're lost. But everybody talks to me like I'm the one. I should change. Why should I change? I never even got to find out who I am, and you want me to change? That's crazy. You think I'm bad before I get to be anything? What is that? Original sin or something? I read Plato. I read him on a park bench, and let me tell you something. Plato wasn't afraid. Diogenes wasn't afraid. Socrates wasn't afraid of anything. They were men. Why are you the headmaster? I'm the student. You understand? Like, I have to earn your respect, but you don't have to earn mine. What is that? It's you that wants the A before you even start. But when I say, I want the same thing. I'm nuts. Right? A miracle for me, but not because of you. Because somebody, Mr. Hoffman, finally saw me! And more than that, somebody, a grown person, decided I was good before I was good. Now you want to throw me out of that? And you know what I can say? I've never met your God.
This is a Catholic school. It's not just about grades. I have to protect the student body from moral peril.
Do you think I'm evil?
Are you?
Time's up. I'm cold. You haven't seen cold. I'll show you cold.
We just have to make it to tomorrow.
We?
Yes, Mr. Kid. Is character destined?
Absolutely not. That would be predestination, and Catholics don't believe in predestination. So you have a choice.
And then you have a choice about whether or not I graduate. You are making me who I am right now.
Right now? What are you talking about? The alcohol rule applies to every student here. I mean, come on, he's gotta go. There's no way.
There is a way. It's here. It starts where we are and goes someplace better. Mr. Schmidt, T.S. Eliot was wrong. The tree is alive. Life doesn't die. I'm 64, Mr. Schmidt, and you're dead, but I have a time machine, and I can speak to great people who have gone. That's the gift I've been given, and I thank God for it. We're all dead, or about to be dead, or we will never die, because the human mind is a leaping spark. I know it. I do worship my ancestors. They're here, with me now. If they make me strive and hunger for greatness,